The third one is A less than the law. For a given amount of gas, the pressure is directly proportional to the temperature. For a given amount of gas, the pressure is directly proportional to the temperature if the volume is constant. Bose Einstein, very low temperature. Acha, what did you write? Pressure is directly proportional to temperature. So P is equals to, we can write K and T, where K is a function of volume, and we can say what K is inversely proportional to volume. Right, the graph. Ah, that is Gaseous law of multiple. There are three laws in the universe when the gaseous molecules combine. So one of the laws is that the universe.
So you say like K1 and K2 stand. Even at last.
Law of multiple proportion, law of definite proportion. One of those ones. Not this one. That is. Okay, we'll take that. Right, so the pressure and temperature graph is what? P and T. V1, V2, V3. And here we have log P and log T. Log P and log T.
So it will be the same.
What is Y intercept?
So maximum volume.
Okay, what is the relation of V1, V2 and V3? The slope is maximum for slope is V1, so V1 is K is maximum, so V is minimum. So V1 is less than V2 and then V3. What about this one, log P and log T? We take log here, log P is equals to log T plus log K. That is same, right? Graph will be like this. Angle will be, slope will be 45. And this distance is nothing but log. But for this thing, K won't be negative. K won't be fractional. because function of volume. And the gaseous molecule has a volume. And there are other things also, temperature also, R value also, there are things. Okay, next write down, last one we have already discussed this, that is Avogadro's law. What is Avogadro's law?
DV equals NRT.
At a given pressure and temperature, the volume occupied by the gaseous molecule is directly proportional to the number of moles. V is equals to right proportional to N, and we can write V is equals to K one note you write down. K is a function of, here we have pressure and temperature both. Directly proportional to temperature, inversely proportional to pressure. Write down if the gaseous molecules or not, you write down. If the gaseous molecules have equal number of moles, then they must have equal number of molecules. This condition is satisfied. Equal number of molecules. But the number of atoms may or may not be equal. Due to difference in atomicity. This question is Can you tell me the number of molecules here and number of molecules here?
Over there it's x by
More number of molecules means more number of moles, and hence more will be the.
So there are some new values, sir. So now there are some new values.
No, this is the value.
So you used to, before you used to give us different values?
No.
So in the textbook it's written that they changed it from using one atmosphere, now they're using some 760 atmosphere, 760.
They will change the millimeter.
No, there's some slight difference. So there's some slight difference, sir. So in NCRT it's different value they use. So now it's like 0.08, something else in the last 2 weeks.
So approximately here. If they change it for the
50
these two you need to memorize, and this is almost equal to this one, because 0.08, if you take, so 8 by 100 is 12 point something. So when you take 1 by 12 instead of 0.0821, that will, no. But you take 1 by 12 sometimes approximation, it will be, calculation will be easier. Okay. So this is the, this equation, we call it as equation of state. Equation of state means what? At two different points, if you try to define the position of a gaseous molecule, you can use this equation. Right? So for a given number of moles at two different points, suppose here, and here if you are trying to define this. Two different positions A and B. You try to define the solution of gas. You require what? You require pressure at this point, PA, volume at this point, PA, temperature at this point, and the number of moles of the gas that you are using. And here it is PB, and the number of moles of the gas. Right? So for a given number of moles, we can write as two positions. We can write VA by C. This is the equation of state. A two different state, we define the position like this.
So the first one, 8.314, which that's for
that's
bars.
Bar.
Right? That's for bars.
When pressure's in bars, you take 8.314.
It's a different
unit.
Yeah, right. It's in joule per mole calorie. SI unit here.
Yes.
Okay.
But this applies only one gas
the BA
by
BA. Yes, one gas in two different positions.
Yo, yeah. The volume and the pressure the same.
Right? PV is equals to NRT is the equation of state. The gases which follows this equation are called ideal gas equations. Okay, so write down this. For a given number of moles, Na and Nb are equal. So this, at this position, will define by Pa, B, and Da. This is the relation. At two different positions for a given amount of gas. Write down. The gaseous molecules.
So if number of moles are not equal, it just be Pa, Ba, by Na, Da.
By any. You have to add that. Any in the denominator. Write down for a. If the gaseous molecules follows the equation of state, it is known as ideal gas. If the gaseous molecules or gases follows the equation of state, it is known as ideal gas. It is the theoretical concept or hypothetical concept, you can write. Hypothetical concept you write down. It is a hypothetical concept. None of the gas behaves as ideal gas, and that is why we also call it as ideal gas equation. Okay, but you have to choose the option between ideal gas equation and equation of state. You have to choose equation of state, not ideal gas equation.
So ideal gas doesn't apply in practice.
Ideal gas actually not possible. There are 2-3 more assumptions also that we'll discuss in kinetic theory of gases. Okay, only matter. See, the other form of this equation, we can write PV is equals to NRT and P number of moles is mass divided by volume into RT by the molar mass of the gas. So mass by volume is nothing but the density. So we can write P is equals to density RT divided by the molar mass of the gas, which is nothing but PM is equals to DRT, where D is the density of the gas, M is the molar mass of the gas. Okay, another way is what? Mole per liter, P is equals to N by V, RT will write. And mole per liter is what? Concentration. Right, concentration is mole per liter, N by V. So we can also write P is equals to CRT. C is the concentration. Molarity. Mole per liter.